This is the OTB Network.
Hello and welcome to Horses and Courses. I'm Jean Wood. Of course, we're here in Saratoga. We've had some great stakes racing action here over the last week, but we've got some great racing action to bring to you from across the country as well. We're going to begin at Monmouth Park, where over the weekend, unfortunately, the weather played havoc with their Saturday stakes card. Nonetheless, we do have three stakes from Saturday afternoon. We're going to begin with the Anderson Fowler and off the turfer. This began as a turf sprint, went at 5.5 furlongs on the main track. Let's head back to last Saturday at Monmouth for the Anderson Fowler.
They're racing in the Anderson Fowler Stakes. Tempt Me Not and He's a Frequent Flyer came out in front of the others. Southwestern Heat will sit off the pace in third, 2 lengths from the front, and it's a gap of another 5 back to Cherokee Country, who's been outrun as they head up the backstretch. Tempt Me Not and He's a Frequent Flyer setting a fast pace, and Southwestern Heat is right behind them in hand in third. The quarter 21-4, and it's 7 lengths back to Cherokee Country. Around the far turn, Tempt Me Not on the outside by a head. He's a Frequent Flyer second. Southwestern Heat swings up 3 wide, and Cherokee Country is going to get involved at some point, starting to gain ground quickly now as they come to the top of the stretch. And it's Tempt Me Not. He's a Frequent Flyer, and now Cherokee Country unleashes his run on the far outside. Last up the backstretch, just a matter of how far he'll win from here. Cherokee Country under the wire, wrapped up to an impressive score, and the Anderson Fowler over He's a Frequent Flyer and Southwestern Heat.
Cherokee Country picking up the victory, a horse that you may remember from over the wintertime in New York. He was an inexpensive claim at Philadelphia Park and has picked up stakes credentials both New York and New Jersey now, winning off by 4 lengths as the favorite, just a tick over even money from He's a Frequent Flyer with Southwestern Heat back in the third spot. Cherokee Country is a bay colt, a son of Yanaguska from Jet Is L by Tri-Jet. Bred in Kentucky by Clarkland Farm and owned by Victory Thoroughbreds Limited, trained by Ramon Preciado and ridden to victory by Jose Lescano. Cherokee Country covers the 5.5 furlongs in 103 and 3. We're going to continue now with stakes racing action from New Jersey in the running on Saturday afternoon of the Continental Mile. This one carded at a mile on the turf for 2-year-olds and unfortunately came off the turf course. Let's head back to New Jersey and the Continental Mile.
Barbosa, own style at the rail, Run Sully Run right off of them. Hop skipping away, hard held, drafting in behind the leaders. And then it's Atoned, Social Quest is right behind them. And Carry the Day is 12 lengths off the lead after a 48 flat half mile. Into the far turn, Barbosa, Run Sully Run right alongside in second. And then it's Atoned to the outside, followed by Hop Skipping Away, who's down at the rail with no place to go. Then Social Quest, Carry the Day, and Own Style is retreated to the back of the field. 3/4 and 1/13 and 4, they're into the stretch. And Atoned has taken the lead. It's Atoned in front, but Hop Skipping Away begins to roll on the outside. And then it's Barbosa and Run Sully Run. Atoned is full of run. Hop Skipping Away is clearly second, but it will be Atoned in Cristo Carlo in the Continental Mile. Hop Skipping Away second, and then came Run Sully Run.
Atoned under Cristo Carlo, picking up a 3-length win from off the pace with a nice wide move to pick up the win over Hop Skip and Away and Run Sully Run, who was involved stalking the pace early before weakening to third. The winner Atoned is a dark bay or brown son of Repent from Amidst by Ice Capade, bred in Florida by Anthony Robinson and Mitzi Robinson, owned by the Dogwood Stable and trained by Todd Pletcher. Ridden to victory by Chris DiCarlo, Atoned covers the mile on the fast track in 1:38.4. We'll head right back down to New Jersey now, and Saturday's stakes feature the Grade 3 Philip Islin Handicap for older horses at 9 furlongs. Let's return to New Jersey and the Islin.
The start. They're off in the Islin. And Gotcha Gold broke well from the inside, but he's not going to go to the front today. It will be Barcola to take the lead. Barcola is the early leader. Now, Chuck Lopez does send Gotcha Gold through on the inside. These two will lead them to the first turn. Indy Wind is right behind them running in third. Then the favorite Master Command, Tastyville, to the outside in fifth. Brother Bobby saves ground into the turn. He's 3.5 lengths off the lead. Poppy Chulo is second last, and Barbican is the trailer. The first quarter, 23 seconds flat. Gotcha Gold has made his way to the front. He's in front by just a head as they go to the back stretch. Barcola right alongside, second a length and a half. Then it's Tastyville in third. Indy Wind is fourth. He's 4 lengths off the lead. Then Brother Bobby. Master Command has 6 to make up. Poppy Chulo is right behind him, and it's 2.5 back to Barbican. Even fractions here, a 46 flat half mile. At the half mile pole, Barcola has his nose in front of Gotcha Gold. Tastyville a length and a half behind. Brother Bobby a contending fourth, and Indy Wind. Master Command hasn't fired yet. He's been passed on the far turn by Barbican, and Poppy Chulo is the trailer. Around the far turn, and Gotcha Gold has put away Barcola. Gotcha Gold is 3 in front. Brother Bobby has moved into second now. Barcola is back to third. Then Master Command and Indy Wind, they're into the stretch. And Gotcha Gold has a 3-length lead. Brother Bobby second, trying to close the gap at the eighth pole. And Master Command is a distant third behind Gotcha Gold and Chuck Lopez, who come to the wire, a 5-length winner of the Islin. It was Brother Bobby second, Indy Wind got up for third, and then came Master Command.
Gotcha Gold manages to pull off another gotcha here, this time at 15-1. This is the horse that actually beat Lawyer Ron in the Salvatore Mile right here at Monmouth Park earlier this season. That one came back to set a track record at Saratoga, yet Gotcha Gold went off at 15-1. Well, winning by 4.5 over Brother Bobby with another long shot, Indy Wind back in the third spot. All of the top choices off the board, including Master Command under Chris DiCarlo, Barbican, and Poppy Chulo, a series of horses all in here for Major Stakes Company in New York, all getting gotcha'd by Gotcha Gold and Charles Chucky Lopez. Gotcha Gold is a 4-year-old bay son of Coronado's Quest from Gotcha Last by Pleasant Tap. Bred in Florida by Centaur Farms and owned by the breeder, trained by Eddie Plaza Jr. and ridden to victory by C.C. Lopez, Gotcha Gold covers the mile in an eighth in 1:48.1. We'll head into Sunday's card now at Monmouth Park, where the stakes feature was the Junior Champion Stakes, $60,000, two-year-old fillies, this time on the turf course at a mile. Let's head back down to New Jersey in the Junior Champion.
Racing and the Junior Champion. Unbridled Rhapsody broke well from the inside and goes out to the front. Right alongside is Rubies Are Forever. These two out the best, and Run for Renee is close up in third. Then Sales Tax, Sammy Van Emmy, Forget About It Gal moves up on the outside of them. Behind that group is Somewhere Over the Rainbow, 5 lengths off the lead. Gap of another 3, and then Tiger at Night, followed by the two trailers, Chatty Ann and Lady Marion. Around the first turn, there goes Forget About It Gal with an early move to take the lead after a 23 flat quarter. Forget About It Gal has taken over and is a length in front as they enter the back stretch. And then it's Rubies Are Forever, Run for Renee to the outside. Unbridled Rhapsody content to sit fourth right now, 5 lengths off the lead. Then Sammy Van Emmy, followed by Sales Tax on the outside. Then it's 2 lengths back to Somewhere Over the Rainbow, 7 off the lead. Then it's Tiger at Night, Lady Marion to the outside, and the trailer is Chatty Ann, a 47 flat half mile. Into the far turn, long shot, Forget About It Gal is the leader. Rubies Are Forever, Run for Renee, and here comes Somewhere Over the Rainbow with a 4 wide move around the far turn. and Lady Marion picks it up outside of Sales Tax. Unbridled Rhapsody coming through traffic, looking for a seam at the top of the stretch and had to steady momentarily there. They're coming to the eighth pole. It's Run for Renee to the outside somewhere over the rainbow. Sales Tax dashing through at the fence. Three lengths back. Tiger at Night starting to finish on well. And Sammy Van Emmy on the far outside. But it's Sales Tax who comes to the wire first. Then a photo between Sammy Van Emmy and Somewhere Over the Rainbow and Tiger at Night.
Sales Tax, Rajiv Marah riding from off the pace to pick up a two-length victory as the favorite at tick or two over the 2-1 mark. After a little bit of a stumbling start, she took a little time to get into stride and rallied strongly to win over Sammy Van Emmy and Somewhere Over the Rainbow, who also rallied quite well while racing wide. The winner, Sales Tax, is a chestnut filly, daughter of High Yield, from Snit by Fit to Fight, bred in Maryland by William M. Backer and owned by the breeder. Trained by Hamilton Smith and ridden to victory by Rajiv Marah, Sales Tax covers the mile on the good turf surface in 1:36.4. We're going to remain in the Mid-Atlantic and head to Delaware Park now in the running on Saturday afternoon of the Par 4 Stakes, $55,000 sprint for two-year-olds. Let's head to Delaware in the running of the Par 4.
And they're off. In the Par 4, toward the outside, Run Jitster Run, Scary Trip, both away well. Quickly speeding up down toward the inside, that's Jet Run, also right there with the rail, Haddonfield. He's Too Smart is next in line, then a gap of 3.5 lengths to Flew By You, the trailer. Scary Trip on the inside, Run Jitster Run on the outside, are going at it head-to-head, 2 lengths to Jet Run, with the rail, that's Haddonfield. 2 more lengths to Ease Too Smart, then a gap of 3 to Flew By You. Opening quarter goes in 22-1 as the two-year-olds make their way to the turn. Scary Trip on the inside. Run Jitster Run is right there on the outside. 2 lengths to Jit Run. Haddonfield trying to get underway. Ease Too Smart alongside, and Flew By You continues the trail as they make their way to the turn. Run Jitster Run now leads it by 0.5 length. On the inside, it's Scary Trip trying to rally on the outside. Jit Run trying to kick in also Haddonfield. Then Ease Too Smart far back to Flew By You. They've gone the half in 45-4 as they turn for home. Run Jitster Run, here comes Jet Run. On the outside, Haddonfield kicking in and down toward the inside. Scary Trip trying to hang in there. Jet Run to the front by 3/4 length. Scary Trip is trying to come back between horses. Run Jitster Run, and on the outside, Haddonfield. It's Jet Run in front. Haddonfield is trying to run him down, but Jet Run is going to win it with Nicky Petro. Haddonfield getting second, Scary Trip third.
Jet Run picking up the win by 1.25 lengths at 3-1 over the favorite Haddonfield, with Scary Trip back in the third spot after giving way late in the stretch. The winner, Jet Run, who's got an interesting name. Fans of Michael Mance, I'm sure, are familiar with the name Jet Run. He made a name for himself in international show jumping competition and board a horse by that name. This one, a 2-year-old gray or roan, son of Wakwite from Crying in the Rain by Baderwood. Bred in Maryland by Mr. and Mrs. Charles McGinnis and owned by Timothy Cunningham, trained by Michael Petro, ridden to victory by Nick Petro. Jet Run covers the 6 furlongs in 1:12 flat. We're going to head to Ellis Park in Kentucky now for the running on Saturday afternoon of the Grade 3 Gardenia. Fillies and mares going a flat mile. Let's head down to Ellis and the Gardenia.
Off and running in the Gardenia Stakes. It's Mia's Reflection, straight out to take the lead. Pleasant Hill, Molly's Pride flashing early speed racing third. Eyes on Eddie taking back along the inside from the four spot. Fiery Pursuit is charging up to the outside. Pleasant Hill dictates the terms. Pressed by Fiery Pursuit, next by 2.5 more. Molly's Pride is tracking in third. Mia's Reflection fourth. Maggie Slew racing in fifth by 2. Eyes on Eddie, 7 lengths off the pace early. Leah's Secret, Brownie points next to her outside. He backs Superb Roddy. Behind that comes Stop a Train and a couple back to High Heels. She's the early trailer, 12 lengths off the pace through the opening quarter mile in 24 2/5 seconds. It's Pleasant Hill and Larry Melanson opening up now quickly by 2 on Long Shot. Fiery Pursuers next by 3 more now. Here comes Brownie Points revving up quickly to the far side, and Leah's Secret following her into stride. Molly's Pride along the inside under pressure. Maggie Slew next, 6 lengths off the pace. Here comes Superb Roddy revving up to the far side, rounding rounding the far turn. Half in 46 and 3/5 seconds. They're coming to get Pleasant Hill, still 3/4 of a length in front. Brownie points and Leah's Secret to pounce on her from the outside. Three back, Maggie Slew shaken up and gaining from the fourth spot now. Eyes on Eddie and Superb Ravi at the top of the lane. It's Pleasant Hill set down by Melanson and responding to the challenge. Cuts the corner a length and a half in front. Brownie points trying to close the gap. She's trying her best to the outside. Far outside, Superb Ravi. It's still Pleasant Hill digging down deep and opening up again. Pleasant Hill, high heels, is flying up the inside. Pleasant Hill, high heels, motoring up the inside. Pleasant Hill wins the Gardenia from a flying high heels who came from last. Brownie points third and Superb Ravi.
Pleasant Hill and Larry Melanson making every step a winning one, winning by a length over high heels, the favorite in the full field of 11, with Brownie points rallying to finish in the third spot. The winner, Pleasant Hill, a Dart Bayer Brown filly, a daughter of Pleasant Tap from Northern Destiny by Crafty Prospector, was bred in Kentucky by the Donemeyer Farm and is owned by the breeder. Trained by Greg Foley and ridden to victory by Larry Melanson, Pleasant Hill covers the flat mile and the fast surface at Ellis in 1:38.4. We're going to pause now for a brief message, and when we return, we'll be heading to Arlington Park for stakes racing action and then out to the West Coast for Del Mar. Please stay with us. Welcome back to Horses and Courses. We're going to continue now with stakes racing action at Arlington Park. On Saturday afternoon, they ran the Arlington Oaks, a grade three for three-year-old fillies. Let's head to Chicago in the Arlington Oaks.
And they're off in the Arlington Oaks. And Marquis, a brilliant break, aspiring, showing speed. And Minnie Sermon is right there, too, from Marquis Delivery, the Darley Maroon of Marietta. At the rail, Humble Janet. And Kiss with a Twist is last as they turn now for that one-mile marker where Marquis takes the point. Marquis going out to lead the Arlington Oaks field, and aspiring is right on her heels. And Renee Douglas has Minnie Sermon up close to this pace. Marquis Delivery is fourth. Humble Janet with the rails. A couple more to the Iowa Oaks winner, Marietta, who's last but one. And Kiss with a Twist is running in seventh. The opening quarter, 25 1/5 seconds. Cisco Torres trying to catch them napping with Marquis. Marquis at this yawning pace with 5.5 furlongs to go. Renee Douglas and Minnie Sermon, most wanted at even money. Right up and on this pace, aspiring is third by two. Marquis Delivery fourth, Humble Janet fifth. Kiss with a Twist now advancing outside of Marietta as they head to the half mile pole. Marquis led soon after the start, and there goes Kiss with a Twist in an instant. E.T. Baird tugged up toward the front with Kiss with a Twist. Half mile in 49.2. Going into the far turn, Kiss with a Twist up now to Marquis as they round the far turn. Marquis just in front of Kiss with a Twist, who made that bull move. Minnie Sermon is three wide, and Aspiring is in hand. Aspiring in the green cap is looking for some space. Marietta coming with an ambitious run, four wide above the quarter pole. Marquis Delivery right there, and Humble Janet is last as they turn for home in the Arlington Oaks, top of the stretch. Three quarters, 1:13.2, Marietta, Minnie Sermon, Kiss with a Twist, battles between horses. Marquis under pressure. On the outside, Marquis Delivery and Aspiring, but it's Marietta who charges to the front as they race up to the wire. Marietta, Mark injury for Owen Hardy. Marietta, a decisive winner of the Arlington Oaks in 1:49.1.
Marietta picking up the win by a length and three quarters over Humble Janet and Marquee Delivery. A very nice off-the-pace rallying move under Mark Guidry by Marietta, who was a horse that was given out to our viewers of the Saratoga News Desk by trainer Owen Hardy, who was very fond of this three-year-old filly. Marietta, a dark bay or brown daughter of Machiavelli and from Minister Wife by Deputy Minister, was bred in Kentucky by Darley and is owned by the breeder. Trained by Owen Hardy, ridden to victory by Mark Guidry, Marietta covers the Arlington Oaks distance of 9 furlongs in 149-1. We'll head out to the West Coast now for racing action at Del Mar, heading back to last Friday in the running of the Rancho Bernardo, a Grade 3 $200,000 sprint for fillies and mares. Let's head back to Friday at Del Mar, the Rancho Bernardo.
And away they go to a good beginning. River's Prayer hops away nicely, better run fast from the inside gate, and there's Lady Gamer going up between them. Those three now line up on the lead. Strong Faith tucked in behind that, and Pussycat Doll will be the early trailer, five off the lead. Past the 5/8 they go, and Lady Gamer now goes on with it. River's Prayer is right there in second. Better run fast, contend to take back into the third spot. Strong Faith is fourth, 4 lengths off the leaders, and a length and a half to Pussycat Doll. Less than a half mile to go now, and Lady Gamer in front by a length to River's Prayer, who's taken a stronghold. She wants to go on with it. Strong Faith and Better Run Faster are joined third. In behind that is Pussycat Doll, still six off the leaders. Coming to the quarter pole in the Rancho Bernardo now. Lady Gamer down at the rail. River's Prayer now breeze down her neck in second. And there goes River's Prayer now. And River's Prayer's the one to beat. She's got the lead and kicking on for home. Lady Gamer's in second. Strong Faith chasing them third. Pussycat Doll trying to get involved from behind. And eighth to go. River's Prayer still the leader. Being chased home by Strong Faith. Pretty much down to these two with a 16th of a mile to go. River's Prayer digs deep, finds more. Strong Faith closing on the outside. River's Prayer's going to win it. River's Prayer a half a length to Strong Faith. Then came Lady Gamer, Pussycat Doll, and Better Run Fast was last.
River's Prayer, a very consistent filly. It seems like she is very strong on any surface, seems to like the all-weather track, sprinting from just off the pace to win by a half a length over Strong Faith with Lady Gamer, the pace setter, back in third. The winner, River's Prayer, a gray or roan filly, a daughter of Devon Lane from Cozy Flyer by Cozine, bred in California by Vessel Stallion Farm Limited and owned by Bantry Farm, Paula Capestro, and Martin Racing Stable, trained by Paula Capestro, and ridden to victory by Clinton Potts. River's Prayer covers the 6.5 furlongs in 117-4. We'll head right back to Del Mar for racing action on Saturday in the Grade 1 Del Mar Oaks for three-year-old fillies on the grass. Let's return to California, the Del Mar Oaks.
And away they go. They all came away smoothly. A rush on for the lead here. Pacified and Forest Melody along the inside want to go on with it. Fleet Caroline now takes a narrow advantage. Super Freaky's right there with Gotta Have Her. Supposition dropping in just behind the leading group, and Tremendous One has to go wide, five off them, then Spend It All Baby. Rutherian has taken back second last, nine off these leaders, and three more to Val Benny. Into the turn they go, and Forest Melody at the rail, and Freet Caroline ensure a fast pace out here. They're going along 2 lengths in front of Gotta Have Her and Super Freaky. Pacified scrapes the paint, 4.5 off these leaders, Tremendous Ones alongside of her. Here's Supposition in the pink cap, traveling nicely, 5.5 off the leaders. Spend It All Baby behind there. Rutherian now starting to improve from behind as 8 lengths off the leaders, and three more to Val Benny. They go down the back stretch in the Del Mar Oaks, and it's still Forest Melody showing the way. A close-up second, Fleet Caroline. Gotta Have Her down at the rail. Then Super Freaky, Tremendous One on the far side, and Pacified in the white at the rail. Supposition is still five off the leaders. Three back to Rutherian. Spend It All Babies drop back second last, and Val Benny's 10 off them. They turn the pressure on in the Oaks, coming to the top of the lane now. Fleet Caroline, Forest Melody, the two to Super Freaky. Supposition in the pink cap. Gotta Have Her looking for somewhere to go. Then Rutherian, Val Benny, Spend It All Baby. Suddenly it's wide open at the top of the lane now. Super Freaky gets the lead. Rutherian explodes down the center though. And Rutherian gets the lead. Here's Val Benny with a late runner there down the center. But Rutherian in a polished performance this afternoon. And
Rutherian and Corey Nakatani take the Del Mar Oaks to Val Benny. Super Freaky was third, then Supposition and Gotta Have Her in a photo for fourth.
The race may be in California, but the filly was shipping in from New York. The winner of the Lake George early in the Saratoga meet heads out to the West Coast for Chris Clement and picks up grade one credentials. Rutherian, a huge kick from off the pace while racing five wide to win by two over the favored 2-1 choice Val Benny, with Super Freaky back in the third spot. Off an impressive victory here at Riding the Hedge, Corey Nakatani takes her wide and Rutherian is now a grade one winner. Rutherian, a dark bay or brown filly, a daughter of Pulpit from Ruthian by Rahi, was bred in Kentucky by the Payson Stud Incorporated, owned by Virginia Craft Payson and trained by Chris Clement, ridden to victory by Corey Nakatani. Rutherian covers the 9 furlongs on the firm turf course at Del Mar in 146.3. Of course, Sunday, a very big day out at Del Mar. A trio of stakes races will kick things off with the Pat O'Brien Handicap for older sprinters. Let's return to Southern California and the Pat O'Brien.
And away they go. All appear to break well. Borden Arrows, Surf Cat on the far side, and Greg's Gold between those two. They go on to lead them. In the fourth spot is Absolute Glory. Soul City Slough is down at the rail, and Publication at the back, 5 lengths off the lead. They go to the 5/8 pole, and Bordenero and Greg's Gold very composed out here, though they're not tearing away. The riders have full control, just letting them run along up front. They've gone clear 3.5. Surf Cat is in the third spot. Soul City Slough down at the rail, and Absolute Glory. They 6 off that leader, and 3 more to Publication. They go past the half-mile pole, and Bordenero's has to pick it up at the rail now, and he kicks on for home. He gets a 3/4 length lead on Greg's Gold, who's still just been patiently ridden in second. Now it's over a length as they pass the 3/8. A gap of 5 back to Surf Cat, Soul City Slough, then Absolute Glory and Publications far back. Coming to the quarter pole now, and Bordenero, but Greg's Gold is absolutely cruising out here. And Greg's Gold now strikes the front, hasn't been asked to run yet. He's kicking on for home. He's going on a length and a half to Bordenero. Whips out on Surf Cat. He's running on. He is the danger now. Greg's Gold, but here comes Surf Cat with a big run down the center. Greg's Gold and Surf Cat, two top-class sprinters in a challenging performance here, but Greg's Gold digs deep. He finds more. The more they asked, the more he gave. Greg's Gold has won the Pat O'Brien to Surf Cat.
Greg's Gold picking up the win is the second choice at 2-1 over the even money favorite Surf Cat, who did run very well to finish second 5.5 lengths in front of Soul City Slough, the third place finisher at 40-1. Greg's Gold, a solid effort from just off the pace. A Roan Gelding, a son of Lake George from Lake Windermere by Fit to Fight, bred in California by Bill Boswell and owned by the breeder, trained by David Hoffmans and ridden to victory by Victor Espinoza. Greg's Gold covers the 7 furlongs on the poly track surface in 1:23.4. We're going to head back to the Del Mar Turf now and the running of the Del Mar Breeders' Cup Mile, $400,000 turf mile for the older horses. Let's head back to California, the Del Mar Mile.
And away they go to a perfect start.
Captain Kurt from the inside, but Crux was away well as well from the outside gate, Langfield, and there's Out of Control going up to join them. Issa Pingo's in the vanguard as well. Frank the Barber tucks in just behind the leaders, then crossing the line, and Zan and Porto Santos taken back last, 8 lengths off these leaders. They go to the 3/4 pole, and Langfield now crosses over, going a good pace, leads it by 1.5 lengths. Out of Control right there, second, and Captain Kurt tucked in third. Issa Pingo's in fourth. But Crux is now 5th, 5 off that leader with Frank the Barber alongside of him. Then comes Zan, crossing the line as second last, gives them 7 length start and another 2 to Porto Santo. No change, all riders happy with their position. They go down the backstretch. Langfield setting a decent pace, 1.5 lengths in front, Out of Control second, and Captain Kurt tucked in third. Issa Pingo's right there 4th, and then Frank the Barber. But Crux is 5 off the leaders, followed by Zan. Crossing the line, being patiently ridden towards the rear, now has 8 to make up, and Porto Santo trails. turning the pressure on as they come to the top of the lane. Now Langfield, but out of control. Breeze down his neck in second and out of control. Now comes to take the lead at the top of the lane. Captain Kurt Isipingo's in with a shot as well. Down the center, crossing the line. Homeward bound and out of control. Here's Bacrux with a nice run in the pink colours on the one from the rail. And Bacrux out of control, suddenly in deep water. He is crossing the line like an express train. Crossing the line, Bacrux. Crossing the line, a superb finish. Crossing the line up to beat Bacrux Isipingo. And taking fourth was Porto Santo.
Crossing the line, crosses the line first. Nice off-the-pace rally under Garrett Gomez, who was out in California to pick up a couple of mounts in Stakes Company. Obviously a profitable trip for Garrett, leaving behind Saratoga for the day. Here he picks up the win over Bicru, who made a very strong rally here, and Isipingo, who completes the order of the top three. The winner crossing the line, a dark bear brown gelded son of Cape Cross from Winds of War by Warhawk, was bred in New Zealand by Mrs. M.D. Wilson, owned by the Double Down Stable Incorporated and McCoyd. Trained by John Sadler and ridden to victory by Garrett Gomez, crossing the line covers the mile on the firm turf course in 132 and 2. Next up, the Grade 1, $1 million mile and a quarter Pacific Classic for older horses. Let's head back to Sunday at Del Mar, the Pacific Classic.
And away they go to the roar of the Del Mar crowd. They all appear to come away beautifully. AP Excellent wants the early lead, and AP Excellent crosses over with Hello Sunday in second. Albertus Maximus, Lava Man, began beautifully from the inside gate. Going to take back into fourth, though. Times Squared has taken a stronghold on the outside. He's pulling his way up. Just in behind that, we have Student Council. Here's Arson Squad in seventh, five off the leaders. Then it's Porfido, Awesome Gem, Big Booster. Sunboat is second last, 11 off them. And the long shot, Salty Humor, is last early. A very sensible pace. They not flying, not crawling either. AP Excellent wanted that lead, and he has an easy one just over a length in front. Hello Sunday's tracking in second. Lava Man's got off the rail. Now Lava Man off the rail has moved up to be third, just two lengths off the leader. Albertus Maximus inside of him. They followed by Student Council, and then comes Times Squared. Here's Arson Squad being niggled out a little. He's nine lengths off the leaders. Four back to Porfido. Awesome Gem is a good 14 off them. Then we come back to Big Booster, Sunboat, and Salty Humor is last. It's a strung outfield in the Pacific Classic. They have a half mile to go. AP Excellence on a loose rein, being asked to kick on with it now. Hello Sunday right there second. Lava Man in the perfect spot. If he's good enough, he had the perfect trip. And Lava Man now goes to tackle from third. Lava Man's going after them into the far turn. Hello Sunday's kicking on with it. Albertus Maximum, Student Council, running a huge one on the outside. Then we come back to Arson Squad, Awesome Gem. The others far, far back. A quarter of a mile to go. Student Council, a huge run on the outside. Lava Man between horses. On the inside, Hello Sunday. Now Awesome Gem is coming with a run. Top of the lane, Student Council looking for a massive upset. Lava Man battling his heart out, but he just can't find. Awesome Gem coming with a strong run down the center. And here comes Awesome Gem like an express train to try to get to Student Council. Student Council's holding him at bay. Student Council and Richard Migliori upset the Pacific Classic field. Awesome Gem, a fast closing second. Then Hello Sunday and Arson Squad ran on for fourth.
It was an upset in all three spots in the trifecta as Student Council was scratched from a money allowance race in Saratoga, picks up the victory in a $1 million event by a half length, holding off the late charging Awesome Gem, who made a huge rally at 10-1. Pressing the pace early was Hello Sunday. He did get to the lead after about a mile, but he was a little bit on the short side late, finishing third at 13-1. Disappointing in the field was crowd favorite Lava Man, the favorite of the bettors, the favorite of many people following racing these days. Lava Man pressed the early pace before backing out of it, finishing up the track for the first time in California in many, many starts. He was off the board, finishing sixth in the field of 12. The winner, Student Council, a bay horse, a son of King Mambo from Class Chris by Chris S., was bred in Kentucky by William S. Farish and is now owned after a very recent purchase by the Millennium Farm, trained by Vladimir Sarin and ridden to victory by New York transplant horse and a New York transplant rider, Richie Migliori, picking up the win in the $1 million event in California. The final time for Student Council in the Pacific Classic, 2:07. And yes, this time is correct, 2:07. And one. We're going to pause now for one more brief message, and when we return, we'll be taking a look at a week's worth of stakes racing action from here in the Spa. Welcome back to Horses and Courses. We're back here in Saratoga, and we've got a week's worth of stakes racing action to review. We'll head right back to last Monday and the running of the Troy, a restricted turf sprint. We'll head back to Monday's card now and the call of the Troy.
And they're off. T.D. Vance is there, mid-watch down toward the inside, and Afrashad splits those two to take charge. Afrashad in front, Mr. Silver now. Second on the outside, midwatch back running in third. T.D. Vance rates in fourth position. Silver Timber is fifth and on the inside, and the early trailer is First Word. Afrashad bowling along with the lead, three quarters of a length. On the outside, Mr. Silver in pursuit, second by another two. Afrashad got that quarter in 22 4/5 seconds. Still in charge as they come to the top of the stretch. Mr. Silver driving hard, second on the outside, and then T.D. Vance midwatch down toward the inside. Off the turn and into the stretch. Afrashad still a tenuous lead as they come into the final furlong. Looking for a way through in between horses, it's Silver Timber. Now he's got a narrow seam, but with clear running on the outside, here's T.D. Vance. T.D. Vance now in front. Now there's room for Silver Timber. Too late, not enough to get to the line before T.D. Vance, who won it by a half a length. Very close for a second there between Mr. Silver and Silver Timber.
T.D. Vance picking up the victory from off the pace. Got the perfect setup here. Garrett Gomez sweeping him into contention to win by a half over Mr. Silver. That was Silver Timber down on the inside, crossing the line in the third place. He was disqualified. Midwatch moved up to the third spot as Silver Timber under Ibar Koa did kind of hustle up into traffic where he had nowhere to go and ended up paying the price for it late. The winner, T.D. Vance, a bay gelding by Rahi out of Freedom of Speech by Danzig, was bred in Kentucky by the TAC Holdings Corporation, is owned by Donald A. Adam and trained by Graham Motion. Ridden to victory by Garrett Gomez, T.D. Vance covers the 5.5 on the turf in 103 flat. We're going to head right back to Saratoga. Continuous stakes racing action on Wednesday. They ran the Grade 2 Adirondack Stakes for the 2-year-old fillies. Let's head back to Wednesday in the Adirondack.
And they're off. Oh, and a tangled start for Phantom Income that has left her well behind the rest of the field. The field moving up the backstretch. And there goes More Happy immediately to the front. More Happy out for the lead. On the inside, Sky Mom is second. B Sharp's down to third. Yonaguchi tugs her way up now. Fourth on the outside, Passion is now fifth. Honest to Betsy races sixth. A to the Croft is now seventh. And I Promise is eighth. And that disastrous start has put Phantom Income in last position, but now she's launching a wide bid as the field rounds the far turn. The quarter, a dazzling 21 4/5 seconds for More Happy, who rolls along with a two-length lead. Yonaguchi is on the chase, second on the outside. Sky Mom is now moving, now third toward the rail. Honest to Betsy makes a move now, up into fourth. A to the Croft, who broke for the rail, is now on the far outside, coming wide into the stretch. And at the top of the stretch, it is still More Happy, who's run a half in 44 and 4 and is at the eighth pole in front by three. Honest to Betsy runs in second. On the outside, eight to the Croft is third. And then it's Yonaguchi, followed by Passion. And they're coming down to the finish. And it's More Happy in front, leg weary, but the winner of the Adirondack by 3/4 of a diminishing length. Eight to the Croft came on well to be second, followed by Passion and Honest to Betsy.
More Happy making it 2 for 2 for Mr. Baffert here in Saratoga, particularly with Offspring of Vindication. But a very nice way to ship into town after abandoning the Del Mar Polytrack surface, a front-end victory for this recent maiden breaker from Southern California. Rallying well from off the pace was A to the Croft. Passion completes the order of the top three. It was indicated that Phantom Income was declared a non-starter after it was found that she had been caused, there was some interference caused by the assistant handler in the starting gate. When she broke, she did begin to rear, and apparently the stewards believed that, and I tend to agree, that Phantom Income was cost that break, and as a result was declared a non-starter. The winner, More Happy, a 2-year-old daughter of Vindication from Apelia by Cool Victor, was bred in Kentucky by Gaines Gentry Thoroughbreds and is owned by John Sikora Jr., Olin Gentry, and Thomas Gaines. Trained by Bob Baffert and ridden to victory by Rafael Bejarano, More Happy covers the 6.5 furlongs in 117 and 2. We'll continue with 2-year-old stakes racing action from Saratoga with the running on Thursday afternoon of the Saratoga Special. Grade 2, $150,000 for the juveniles. Let's head back to Thursday and the Saratoga Special.
And they're off. Little Nick bounces right out of there. Riley Tucker comes out running too. And on their inside, Kodiak Cowboy. Betatron is away running in fourth, followed by Make the Point. And it's 4 lengths back to the roundhouse, who does his running from off the pace. So down the back stretch run, and it's Little Nick in front with a host of pursuers, though. Moving through between horses, Riley Tucker now up to grab the lead. The quarter in 22 seconds flat, and now it's Riley Tucker in front. Little Nick second on the outside, Kodiak Cowboy on the inside of Betatron. Make the Point, looms just about 3.5 lengths from the front. Another 5, back to the roundhouse. Garrett Gomez asking the roundhouse to pick it up now as they round the far turn. Little Nick sparring here with Riley Tucker. And it's Little Nick on narrow lead, turning for home. Riley Tucker right there. Betatron swings into action on the outside. Kodiak Cowboy looks for a way through, and here he comes. But the roundhouse is coming too, and they're coming into the final furlong. And Kodiak Cowboy has come bursting through between horses as the roundhouse tries to reel him in. 100 yards from home, Kodiak Cowboy and the roundhouse. And Kodiak Cowboy, who muscled his way on through in mid-stretch, comes on to win the Saratoga Special by 3.
Kodiak Cowboy taking perfect advantage of a sharp pace up front, sitting just off the early pace under Sean Bridgmahan, pouncing at the top of the stretch. A late lead change didn't cause him any trouble. A 3-length victory over the late moving the roundhouse, with Riley Tucker pressing the pace early and sticking around for third. The winner, Kodiak Cowboy, is a bay colt. He is now a multiple graded stakes winner, a son of Posse from Cocodrie by Coronado's Quest. Bred in Kentucky by the Hartwell Farm and owned by Vinery Stable and Fox Hill Farm. Trained by Steve Asmussen and ridden to victory by Sean Bridgmahan, Kodiak Cowboy completes the 6.5 in 115 and 4. We'll move on to the Saratoga Turf next with the running on Friday afternoon, rather, of the Lake Placid for 3-year-old fillies. Of course, Rutherian was conspicuous by her absence. Of course, she turned up in Southern California to win a Grade 1. In the meantime, we had an exciting renewal of the Lake Placid. Let's head back to Friday.
And they're off. Christmas Kid, new addition over to the rail. Far outside Limoncella, and here's Sharp Susan. And Sharp Susan is up for the lead as they race for the first turn. Limoncella now back second on the outside. Christmas Kid reined in to run back in third. New addition in a bit tight now down toward the inside is new addition. On the outside, Christie's Treasure. Around the clubhouse turn, Sharp Susan out there, length and a half. Limoncello runs in second, Christmas Can Well held, third on the inside. Christie's Treasure is now fourth, New Edition fifth, only three from the front. A break of two back to Clifton Bay, followed on the inside by Communique, and Lady Attack is allowed to linger at the back of the pack after a quarter and 23 and 4/5 seconds. By Sharp Susan, the leader by a length. Limoncello continues along in second position, and then Garrett Gomez has a good hold there of Christmas Kid, who's rating comfortably while third. Christie's Treasure stays up on the pace in fourth. New Edition remains in mid-pack fifth. And on the outside, it's Clifton Bay, followed by Communique. Three or four back to the still unhurried Lady Attack into the far turn. After a half of 47 and 2/5 seconds, it's still Sharp Susan in control. Christmas Kid just on the inside of Limoncello. On the outside, Christie's Treasure runs along in fourth. New Edition in behind a wall of horses in fifth. From the back of the pack, Lady Attack is revving up, and here she comes with a bold move on the far outside at the top of the stretch. The leader is still Sharp Susan. Sharp Susan, the leader by a length and a half. Christmas Kid runs in second. New Edition is third. Lady Attack continues the closing move on the outside. It's still Sharp Susan, the leader. Sharp Susan there by two. New Edition, final try, Lady Attack. Sharp Susan and Kent DeSormo took her wire to wire to win the Lake Placid by two. New Edition was second and Lady Attack was third.
Sharp Susan getting to the front and staying there. Filly who's had good early speed, although it has been a little bit tough to hold on the front end on some of these turf courses at Saratoga. The latecomers have been making their bid successfully, but Sharp Susan held them all at bay by a length and a half over New Edition, with Lady Attack, who had run a very good second to Rotherian, coming back to finish third. The winner, Sharp Susan, a dark Bayer Brown 3-year-old daughter of Touch Gold from Winters Gone by Dynaformer, was bred in Kentucky by the Windstar Farm and is owned by IEAH Stable and Windstar Farm. Trained by Bill Bott and ridden to victory by Kent DeSormo, Sharp Susan completes the mile and an eighth on that firm turf course in 146.3. We're heading into the weekend now. Some great stakes racing action. Going to kick things off with the New York State bred fillies or mares in the Yaddo Handicap on Saturday afternoon on the grass. Let's get back to last Saturday's running of the Yaddo.
And they're off. Down inside, it's Half Heaven looking for the early lead. From the outside, here comes Factual Contender now. And Factual Contender up for the lead. Half Heaven taken back to run in second position early on. Latitude 40 now, up with the leaders running in third. Artistic Express is fourth, and Symphony of Psalms is a well-held fifth toward the inside. Homerette is sixth, Najima seventh on the inside, and J. Ray is eighth in the opening quarter mile here. Minina Rose took Sabalina wide into the turn. Up front, Factual Contender sails along on an uncontested lead. She's clear by two from Latitude 40 after a quarter and 24 seconds flat. Half Heaven is an unhurried third. Artistic Express fourth on the outside. Symphony of Psalms remains well in hand in fifth position. Najima finds an opening to her inside. And then it's J. Ray, who's still about eight lengths from the lead and in the clear on the outside. Homerette, Minina Rose, and Sabalina. Midway down the backstretch, Factual Contender allowed an opening half mile of 48 3/5 seconds. Still uncontested as they hit the far turn, it is still Factual Contender in control. Latitude 40 continues on in second. On the outside, it's Half Heaven third in Najima, fourth toward the inside. J. Ray still about six lengths from the front as they come to the quarter pole. Symphony of Psalms still bottled up at the rail. At the top of the stretch, it's Factual Contender. Najima trying to come through an opening on the inside, very tight for her. Latitude 40 is there. Symphony of Psalms runs to daylight now as they come into the final furlong. And Latitude 40 comes away with the lead. Factual Contender now running second. On the outside, Half Heaven and Symphony of Psalms, but it is Latitude 40. Latitude 40 has won it by two lengths, the upset winner of the Yaddo.
Little bit of an upset here as Latitude 40 makes the last best move under Kent DeSormo, who's just been owning the Saratoga turf course up here. Very strong effort from just off the pace to win over Factual Contender and late charging Symphony of Psalms. Latitude 40 is a dark bay or brown filly, a daughter of Chester House from Planchette by Buck Point, bred in New York by Paul Hoffman and Doreen Honold, owned by the DZ stable and trained by John Hertler. Ridden to victory by Kent DeSormo, Latitude 40 covers the mile and an eighth on the firm turf in 147.4. We'll head right back into Saturday stakes racing action, the Grade 1 mile and a quarter Alabama for three-year-old fillies. Let's head back to Saturday and the call of the Alabama.
And they're off in the Alabama. Mooncatcher toward the inside. Right alongside her, there's Panty Raid. An octave is forwardly placed, and so too is Folk on the outside, and Tuft Is a Sis. And Tuft Is a Sis will go head-to-head in the first furlong here with Folk. Octave tucks in behind him over to the rail. Lady Joni is forwardly placed today on the far outside and running along and forth. Then Panty Raid and Lear's Princess together to break a 4-5. Mooncatcher's at the back of the pack as they round the clubhouse turn. Tuft Tis a Sis is the pacemaker, and Folk sits chilly while running along in second. Lady Joni is third on the outside after a quarter in 23 2/5 seconds. Octave at the rail, saving ground fourth. Two lengths back, Panty Raid is just in behind Octave now. And to her outside is Lear's Princess, three lengths back to Mooncatcher, who is trailing the field beyond a half mile in 47 2/5 seconds. The pace is honest. And now, there goes Folk after the lead. 5 furlongs from the wire, and Folk is making a move for the lead. Tuft Is a Sis battles her right back. Those two head-to-head as they approach the half-mile pole. Lady Joni sitting just outside of Octave, who's been saving ground fourth throughout. Then a break of 2.5. Panty Raid gets a little nudge there. No response yet from Panty Raid. On the outside, it's Lear's Princess. Long way back to Mooncatcher. And now there's 3 furlongs to go here. 3/4 up in 1:11.1. Tuft Is a Sis, battling on gamely on the inside. Here's a 4-wide move here by Lear's Princess as they come to the top of the stretch. And Lady Joni is right there. Octave is down inside a tiring horse, Tuft Is a Sis. And they're off the turn and into the stretch here in the Alabama. And it is Lady Joni who's come away with the lead at the eighth pole. Octave looking for a way through on the inside. And here comes Octave with a bold late run. And on the outside, Lear's Princess. A thrilling finish in the Alabama. It's Lady Joni in front. Octave and Lear's Princess surging. Lady Joni and Lear's Princess. Here's the wire. Lady Joni has won a thriller by a neck. Beating Lear's Princess here, Octave was third.
It was a very exciting stretch run, and actually it was about 10 minutes after the race that it became official that we really knew who was the winner of this race, as Lady Joni crosses the line first and keeps that victory. A little bit of race riding on the part of Calvin Burrell to maintain his position inside. It's not easy to ever try and shoot the rail on Calvin. John Velasquez tried it on Octave, wasn't quite able to get through, and saw that hole close up rather quickly. Lady Joni did bear out just a little bit after putting Octave away into Lear's Princess, but she was left up on top under Calvin Burrell with the win by a neck over Lear's Princess. It was another length and a half back to Octave. The winner, Lady Joni, is a three-year-old filly, a daughter of Orientate from Oatsy by Unbridled. Bred in Kentucky by Bentley L. Smith and owned by the breeder, trained by Carl Navsker and ridden to victory by Calvin Burrell, Lady Joni covers the mile and a quarter on the fast main track in 2:03.3. The final stakes race of the weekend, Sunday afternoon's running of the restricted John's Call on the turf at 1 5/8 for the older horses. We'll join the John's Call in progress.
So it's a tight pack that meanders through an opening half mile in 51 4/5 seconds. And General Jumbo now has a narrow advantage into the turn with Stratostar second on the inside. So those two vying for the lead here. On the outside, it's Swagger Stick, a narrow third over Evil Storm. Making their way into the backstretch run. Stratostar and General Jumbo continue to match strides on the lead. Swagger Stick tugs up now, third. On the outside, lead with your chin. Right up with the pacemakers now in fourth. Then it's Evil Storm, fifth toward the inside. Rousing Victory, Malibu Moonshine revved up. And 3 lengths to Belador. Down the backstretch run, 3/4 up in 1:17.2. And now it's General Jumbo by a neck, but right back at him, Stratostar. On the outside, Swagger Stick, sitting chilly while third. At the fence, Evil Storm runs in fourth, less than a half mile to go now. And then it's Rousing Victory. Lead with your chin continues on the far outside. Revved Up hasn't been asked for anything yet. very strong, sixth on the inside, but still five lengths behind is revved up. Then Malibu Moonshine, last of all, and last throughout Belador, around the far turn. And there goes Rousing Victory. Rousing Victory now charging up on the far outside. Up and after the lead as the field turns for home. And Revved Up has running room now. And Revved Up is revving up on the far outside. At the rail, General Jumbo. The three of them headlong into the final furlong. General Jumbo, Revved Up, Rousing Victory now third. Belador is fourth. Inside the final 16th, it is Revved Up in front. And confidently ridden by Kent DeSormo, Revved Up has won by two, and it was very close at the finish for second money there between General Jumbo and Belador.
Revved Up, a major graded stakes winner over the course of the last few years, picks up the victory here in restricted company by a length and a half as the even money favorite over long shots General Jumbo and late charging Bayador, who rallied from very well back off the early pace. The winner, Revved Up, a gray or roan, 9-year-old gelded son of Sultry Song from Win Approval by With Approval. He was bred in Florida by the Live Oak Stud and is owned by Live Oak Plantation, trained by Christophe Clement, and ridden to victory by who else? Kent DeSormo. Revved Up picks up the mile and 5/8 victory in the John's Call in 2:42.3. That'll wrap up a busy edition of Horses and Courses. Thank you very much for having joined us this week. We hope you'll be able to join us again next week for stakes racing action from around the country. Until then, I'm Jean Wood. Have a great week at the races.